Hey, welcome back to Dark Cloud 2. Blue seal. See, I don't mind the blue seals. Those are fucking fine with me. It is a little weird to me. I was looking at the... It's not really an overworld, but the sort of level selection screen. And it seemed a little strange, but the level selection screen split off really quick. Time coin. I think I already have one of those. I'm just gonna hope that this footage is sped up rather than me just standing here doing nothing. But I am gonna just stand here and do nothing for a little bit, because I fucking need the health back. And standing here getting health back as slowly as I am, it's one every like 8 seconds, I think. I'm not above standing here and waiting for fucking 10, 15 minutes to get all my health back. If I'd have to use all my healing items, that would annoy the shit out of me. Or I could have just run into this fucking room. You know, having a healing fountain is pretty fucking useful. I don't want to use up my healing items. I wonder if that affects the, like, do a thing without healing goal. I found the exit I'm allowed to use. God, man. When am I going to be allowed to use these other exits? I've been playing this game for a very long while now. I think I've gotten more than 60, 70 hours on this game. And I already know that there's like a... I know that there's a point in the game where I'm going to be allowed to actually use the other exits in these levels. But I don't know when that point is. And it feels like it's taken fucking forever for me to get there. You know what I miss about having a different gun? Because this one does a lot of damage. I like that. And I'm kind of over the it slowly killing me thing. It's a punishment for sure. I don't like the gun having that on it, but I'm kind of over that being something that makes me upset every damn time it happens. I miss having a gun that does damage at the same rate at a distance as it does up close. I know that's not entirely true, but it's pretty close to true in certain cases. In this one, like, the difference between standing this far away and right next to him can be pretty stark. I'm not really too happy about having to stand real close to use a weapon that is supposed to be a ranged weapon. This one was pretty easy. The only weird thing in it was like a tree and a fat thing, and that was it. So this one I can get through with pretty quick. I need to level this gun up like a whole lot more. At the point that I'm kind of sitting at right now, it's going to take forever for me to do anything with it. And I know that the strategy I'm supposed to use is probably level up another gun and level up all of its shit. And with all of that stuff leveled up to where I need it to be for this one, I can use it on this one. But that doesn't feel like it's gonna go any fucking faster. Cause I need a shitload on each one of those things. So I need 160 just to get this thing up to where I need it to be. That's going to require, regardless of anything, me leveling up a shitload of things. So I'm probably going to have to use, like, a couple of guns. I guess maybe that's the way I ought to do it. I guess I should try that, huh? So I'll just level it up a few times, give this one 40 flame. I think that probably can do 40 on this and then on the smash as well. What do I need for that? I need 20 for smash, 18, but then I need 39 for flame. So I can do that. So I'll try, and then I can level up this one more time and see if that'll let me use all of the flame and all of the smash from that gun. Because if it does, then That'll even it up, I think. Well, it seems like the gun that I'm using can't be upgraded that much. The highest that I can get flame to go is 34. So I guess that means that the plan to try and get it up to 40 for the flame and then 20 for the smash, I'm just gonna have to do 34 for the flame, 20 for the smash, and maybe I'll put some other stuff into it if I've got the points left for it. Because it's possible I'll have the synthesis points left. Well, I'm left with the thought that I'd like to go ahead and do that today. I want to go ahead and spectrumize the gun today, but that's kind of difficult to do. Spectrumizing it's not difficult, but actually applying it to my gun would be, because this one has to level up before I can do that. For the last little while, I had sort of settled on doing three of these little things per episode, but doing four of them, I guess, ain't too bad. This is a long fucking dead end. I hadn't seen one of these. I don't think in any of the levels I've played across all the chapters I've done so far, I don't think any of them have had a long fucking dead end like this one before. Okay, so it gives me about half of whatever the thing is. That doesn't really feel all that useful to me. I mean, I'll spectrumize it. It gives me a lot more points. So I guess it is useful. It's just, it's not as useful as I wanted it to be. These aren't giving me a lot of experience points or anything. So I'm not crazy about how many of these motherfuckers I'm actually gonna have to kill just to get the XP that I need for this thing to level up. Because it looks like it's going to be at least four more of them to get up to the level I need it to be. I don't know how many of these are in one stage, and this stage is possibly really big, but I don't know. It might nearly be clear for all I know. I severely underestimated. That Griffin soldier looked like it gave me a whole lot more fucking XP than these other things are. Maybe I get less XP for different things. Maybe I get more or less depending on what I fight, but it felt like I was getting way, way more. And that might be true and it might not be. Three more enemies, possibly four, but I hadn't seen any mimics in this one, so I'm thinking three more enemies. I don't think I'm gonna level up this gun today, as disappointing as that is. But I'd like to level it up today and see if at the very least I can get something fucking done. I want to make some progress. And it doesn't always feel like I'm making progress even if I get the level. Ooh, that's a big motherfucker. And you die pretty easy. Please give me a whole lot of XP. Last enemy. Didn't even give me nearly as much as I thought it would be. Well, shit. I wanted to make progress, but I've been playing for fucking ever. I don't like the idea of sitting here and playing through a whole bunch of shit, making the file size fucking an hour and a half long and everything for me to barely make progress, because I'm really not making very much. It would just put the gun up a little bit, not by all that much, so I'm not really happy with doing that. Let's see what I got in the Georama. Geostones gave me stair block, generator, second floor of workshop restored, resident in house with chimney, third floor workshop restored, Gundorada workshop, workshop elevator, Work crane, work arm, 100 culture points. God, that's gonna take a while. And what is left? A bunch of shit, obviously, but I guess second floor needs to be done and 30 culture points. And I guess resident in a house with a chimney does tell me something. It, there's not a whole lot here that says pretty much anything other than, oh, resident in house with chimney is on a few of these. So I guess there's something I can do real quick. So my culture points are a 9. That means nothing. All right, well, I guess I know what that one is. I've got 3 things completed here. I need a lot more culture points. 3 sturdy houses. Oh, I don't have anything called a sturdy house, do I? No, I don't have any sturdy houses. I just have brick houses. So I guess I need to keep going through levels to unlock even more stuff. So this was completely pointless in that case. I guess I'm gonna get rid of that. Borneo can fucking move back into the train. I'm done for the day, since nothing that I can do, there's nothing that I can do right now. That I'm just finished. I hope you enjoyed this one, though, and I hope you come back for the next one. I'll see y'all later. Bye.